Hey everybody, welcome back to the Metal Mill 52 Workshop. My name is Bill, this is my shop, working on an LBSC Tich locomotive. That's what the book looks like. This is what the actual locomotive project looks like. Spending a lot of time on the tanks lately, and there's a lot to it. And I had hoped, if you've been following along, I had hoped to complete this and publish this video with the tanks completely done, all the fittings and everything done. Well, you can see I've pulled out some of the fittings and the piping and stuff here. So I just realized I've got like 20 minutes worth of footage here of the various bits and pieces of making this thing, and I'm not nearly done, and it's going to be a while before I'm complete. So I wanted to go ahead and publish this video. I'll call it Tanks Part 2, and I'll do a Part 3 when they're complete and show you all the connections and stuff. So hope this is useful to you. Please ask any questions that you might have. If you don't have questions but you'd like to encourage me, please hit that thumbs up button. I would sure appreciate it. It always motivates me when I see the thumbs up that people are enjoying the content. So without further ado, here comes about 20 or 25 minutes worth of stuff about making the bottoms, installing the bottoms and tops and the filler tops on the tanks. And it was fun, and I hope this will be useful. Hope you enjoy. Take care, everybody. Here's the 1/16 inch thick brass angle stock that I got from Online Metals. I bought 2 3-foot pieces of this. And it's really nice stuff. It drills really well. Let me get the camera over here where you can see it. It drills really well. It's nice and square. So I outlined it about 90 thou down from the top. I laid out the holes and just drilled. These are tapping size holes for 172 screws. I've done that on both sets, excuse me, of the angle that'll go in the bottom of the tanks. This is the set for the left-hand tank. And I'm getting ready to just clean these with acetone, and I cleaned the inside of the tank. So I'm gonna get ready to crazy glue them in place. Same process that I used for these angles that I used to hold the tank sides together. So I'll crazy glue them in place, then take the tanks apart and drill and tap the units together like I did with the other part. I'll bring you back and show you how that is progressing. Just a quick shot. Here I'm using the pillar tool, the tapping function on it, to tap the 1-72 holes. This is the outside piece of brass. I've got the angle, the pre-drilled angle, crazy glued in just to the side. So I'll tap this all along, then I'll put screws in, and then I'll be able to put it in position on the base and tap the base. I think what I'm going to do is use round head screws, button heads, on the outside that'll look like rivets, and then I'll use flat heads that I'll countersink from the bottom so it'll fit flat. Here's the tanks with the 172 button head screws. This is what they look like. They're tiny little things as well. And installed on the bases of either side. So the next thing I've got to do here is on the other side. I used fewer screws because the side is shorter. Next thing I need to do now, I've got that all fit together, take this all apart, clean on the inside, clean away the crazy glue, use the hot gun to remove the angle from the sides, then screw it back together, at least just to hold it in place, and glue the inside of the bottom of the angles to the base material here. Then I can repeat the process, drilling and tapping. And here's the bottom of the tank. I've got the angles just gently bolted in with a couple of screws on either side. I've cleaned it all with acetone, and I've got the crazy glue. It's a nice snap fit in there for the bottom. I'm really pleased about that. So now I'll take these side screws out, and hopefully the bottom will come loose with the angles attached to it. Well, that worked out perfectly. I took the screws out, set it down, and kind of pressed on the front and rocked the case back, and it came off clean. So this is what I've got. Now it's all perfectly set up. I can go ahead and drill and tap these holes, and I'm going to countersink the bottom so I can use flathead brass screws so the bottom will sit flush. Very excited about this. Okay, here's the base for the left side tank, and got all the screws countersunk. You can see these are the number 1 with 72 threads per inch flathead screws, brass screws. Probably didn't need this many screws. And one thing I, you know, kind of goofed up on is I put these screws adjacent to right across from the screws that will go into the side. Really should have offset them. It made it a lot easier. I wouldn't have to cut these off. But as you can see, these are all very long, so I'm going to have to cut them off. I'm going to try to do it with a hacksaw. Might be able to do the whole row of them at once and then flip it over and do the other. And then I'll bring it back and test assemble everything to the tank. And if everything checks out, then I'll take this back out. And I do need to heat the crazy glue, take all the screws out, heat the crazy glue, and remove the screws, clean the excess crazy glue off, and then that tank, the bottom will be done. Well, that worked out really good. I used the hacksaw. I did this the opposite side first, just laid the blade there and sawed it off, and about halfway through these screws here, just the brass screws are nice and easy to saw through, so that'll help immensely. I'm a little bit better when I'm not trying to film it, so I'm gonna stop filming here. Okay, there's the assembled tank with the little rivet look button head screws. I like how that looks. It's kind of like how I like to build things. So there's the inside and the bottom. So the tank is sturdy, secure. It's obviously not finished yet. I need to do things, the fitment for the water pump. So one thing I noticed, let me tilt this so you can see in the light. You can see I marked the screws that protrude with a black marker. I'm going to need to take those things out one by one and cut them off, because the, I don't know if this will show up or not, the pump base is, the good news is it's narrow enough to fit inside the angle iron pieces. Bad news is that the screws interfere with it, so I'm just take those all out and cut them off, and we'll try another test fit. To shorten the screws, I made a little jig here out of this 1/8 inch thick bed frame angle iron, which will be perfect because it's about, you know, 1/8 of an inch or 125 thou. The material we're going through is about 90 thou total, so this will give me, I'll just take the hacksaw here and cut it off level, and I'll have the perfectly length screws, just a tiny bit more than the length needed. Okay, it's been a productive day. Things don't look that different, but I've got the bottoms installed in the tanks. Really pleased with how that came out. Let me show you the right-hand side one, since I dwelled on the left. So I countersunk all those holes. Got the little rivet head looking pattern here. And I cleaned off all the, it's hard to see, cut off the excess of the ones inside. So next step will be to work on the tops, which I've already got the blanks for cut out. So next time. The next thing is to work on the tops. So here's my template for the oversized tank top. And here's the blanks that I cut out. I think my next step with these is, it's been so long I can't remember, but I'm gonna check them square and file the edges down, get some finished edges there, and then put it in the milling machine and mill out that pattern there on both of them. Another thing I'll point out, I'm gonna make the tank combing, if you will, the top a little bit higher than the 1/2 inch that it calls for, because of the stub of the pump that sticks out. It's sticking out a little higher due to the fact that the pump body is on, it's resting on those 1/16 inch by 1/16 inch angle brass pieces. And finally, my final thought is, after I make the tank tops and fasten them down, then I'll be able to accurately locate exactly where I want the pump to go. I mean, it's adjustable a little bit. I can move it back and forth about 1/2 inch. I can move it back and forth 1/2 inch. So once I have the tank made and fast top made and fastened down, then I'll know exactly where the pump can go, can take the tank off, mark the holes, and drill the mounting holes. Just thought I'd show the process of cutting out the center holes. I drilled with an 1/8-inch drill in all four corners, and then I'm using an end mill to very slowly and carefully cut out the brass. It'll make a nice clean hole, hopefully minimal filing involved when I get done. There we are, moments later. That's a pretty clean hole. Pretty happy with how that turned out. So now to do the next one. After machining the slot for the little tunnels in the tank covers, I made a little cardboard template of the piece that sticks up and test fit it in there. It's a good fit. So now I've laid it out on some 1/32 inch brass stock and made my bend lines there. So I'm going to bend this piece up and then test fit it in. I may have to enlarge the slot a little bit, obviously taking into account the thickness of the material here. But we'll see how that goes, and it'll be a simple process. I can put it on the mill and just enlarge it by a few thou on either side if necessary. Okay, here's the first one after making full bends in the machine here, the bending machine. The bends are all in the right place, it seems like, but obviously when I crimped, I obviously messed up the crimping a little bit. It's because it's such a tight bend in the machine. So what I'm going to have to do is take this now, just go over to the vise and hammer it out and hammer it into form. Hopefully it'll come to the exact right. But I think with the next one I can make full bends on the end pieces, and maybe for one of these, but I'll just need to make a little half bend and then finish it on an anvil type thing on the vise. The first iteration of the little combing, I don't know what you call these things, but the upper part of the tank, on a boat you'd call it a combing. The first one, making it on the Benford 3-in-1 machine, was a little tricky, as I showed a minute ago. So I broke out this small bender here that I got from a friend of my buddy Fred, that was an automotive enthusiast. It had this small thing. I think this is a Harbor Freight. It's about 18 inches long. It's a great size for small stuff like this. So I think this is going to work out good. I've made the end bends, and I've just lined this thing up with the square to make the this one of the middle bends, and I'll bring you around in a minute and show you the final bend. Okay, yeah, this worked a lot better. If you can see, I'm just finishing the bend here. I was able to stick the other side. I had to unbolt it and lift it up, but that's very clean. Really pleased with how that came out. I'm sure there'll be some fine-tuning adjustments, but it shows you that having a different option is very handy. Matter of fact, I might put the other one in here just to flatten it out and clean up my bends a little bit. All right, let me show you the contrast. This is the one that I just came off the flat angle bender here. And this is the one from the 3-in-1 machine. After massaging it, trying different things, crimping it, you can see how goofed up my corners are and my angles. It's just terrible looking. So I'm going to redo this one here, absolutely. Go take it over to the flat bender and redo it. Here's an interesting example of what I mean when recovering. This is the part that I made first that I kind of mangled using the 3-in-1 machine. And what I did, I heated it up with a propane torch to anneal it, dipped it in some water, and then pounded it flat on a vise with a ball peen hammer. And now I've did the same thing, of course, to this side. You can see it's pretty straight and flat. And I've just marked it. The longer mark there is for the half inch, so that's the bend line. So I'll be able to put it in the little 18-inch Harbor Freight bender and bend it just exactly like I did the other one. I'll show you what I mean in a second, and we'll see how clean it is. Well, a little remedial work and several heatings and reshapings, but this one came out really nice, so I'm pretty happy with that. It's a little smaller. I think this one will go on the opposite side, so the viewport, so to speak, for the bypass valve. And this one, which was the first one, or the second one I did, and the first one I did on the little flat bender, came out beautiful. And all I've got to do, just open up the hole here. I'll put this back in the mill and run my little eighth inch end mill out to get the width correct. The length is about right, maybe a little shy. I can file that or mill it. And that's exactly what I was hoping to achieve, to custom fit it so that make these things so they just fit in. All right, now that I've drilled and tapped the little angle brass pieces for the top, give you a little bird's eye view of what that looks like. Now I can take the halves apart again and then drill and tap along the sides, and then those angle pieces can be permanently mounted. Then I can repeat the process like I used for the bottom, unglue, scrape all that off so that these angle pieces are clean and removable, and glue the tops on, drill and tap those, and then clean them again, and then I'll be able to finish the tops with the little boxes and the lids. I have yet to make the lids. Okay, it's been a good afternoon of work out here. I got these inner angle brass pieces installed, bolted into the tops of the tanks, and I just crazy glued. What you're looking at is the upside down version. I've crazy glued these in place, and now I'll come back and drill and tap those holes. I put four holes in the top on each side so I can fasten the tank top down. I wanted to get that all done first, and then I can fabricate the little lids that will go on there. Okay, the little angle brackets are all screwed in and fitted, and everything seems perfect there. I haven't soldered the combing parts down yet, but I thought I'd make the lids, so I've made a little template for the lid, and I've got the material laid out to cut out there. I'll do that tomorrow and show you that process, and we'll be almost finished with the metal forming stuff for the tank. Okay, I'm fabricating the little lids for the filling tubes. I was a little worried about this at first, but the first one came out pretty decent. Obviously, it's not done yet. But I basically just formed the 3/16 inch center section with the use of a vise and then some needle nose pliers to bend it around. And I basically did the same thing with these other, the tabs for the lid itself. And it's not, like I said, it's not perfectly done yet. I just wanted to kind of prove the concept. So here's the pieces for the one for the left-hand side. This is what it looks like. This will be the center portion here. And so you just want to make those fit. And what I've been doing is taking them over. I heated them up and quenched them so that they'll bend easier. So I'll just heat them up with a propane torch and make it a lot easier to bend that way. Okay, we made the little flapping lids. Really was not that difficult. They're not works of art. I wish they were prettier, but I'll spiff them up a little bit. Now that those are made, and you can see this one I made a little long because I wanted to make it easy to flip open to put the pump handle in. That one is a little shorter, but so that's by design. But I cut some little pieces here because I need to bridge the gap on the back here where I bent the filler thing. So I'm going to silver solder these in first on both filler spouts, and then my plan is to silver solder this in as well, and then probably silver solder this together in the filler tubes inside the tops. Not really an action shot, but could be helpful to somebody making one of these. This is the left-hand side. I've just soldered the tab on. First I did the joining one in the back, and then I've soldered on this tab here in the front to hold the hinge on. So I just wanted to show the setup. I've got it in between a couple of fire bricks. So now that should be ready to dunk in the pickle and test it and see if I made a good. Here's the tank fillers with the lids silver soldered on. I've got both of them. Pretty happy with how that came out. We'll have to see what the finished product looks like. I need to clean up that soldering, a little blobby there, but pretty good shape. So my next move here is to take the tops off, the tank tops off, and clean the area there, and then soft solder the filler into it on each side. You can see the look, the coppery look is because both of the brass tank filler lids have been in the pickle. Okay, pretty happy with how these came out. The little filler boxes in their lids, got them soldered all the way in. So I'm going to let them dry overnight and maybe tweak them a little bit tomorrow. The next main thing will be working on fitting the water pump itself, permanently fastening it to the base of the left-hand side and making sure that I get it in the right spot for the hatch there. I'll bring you back for that detail. When I was trying to peen over the ends of the pin on the right-hand lid, I bent the pin. It's just a piece of 3/32 inch brass, and I bent it badly, and it bent the hinges. So I took that out. That's the one I took out, put in a straight piece, straightened it out again, and now it closes nicely. So just wanted to point out, you might have to be careful if you try to peen over the ends. You could mess up your little hinge work. My pump, the base is wider than the inside piece, so it's resting on the 1/16 inch brass angle. And it's kind of awkward because if I were to drill the holes for the base mounts, they would be halfway on and halfway off those angle irons. So what I decided to do, I took the top angles out so I could get to everything. Then I used some calipers to measure the inside distance, and I just scribed that on a piece of 1/16 inch brass. I'm going to decide to the exact length I need tomorrow, cut this off, and then I'll fasten that in as an additional support for the base. It'll level things out and allow me to drill holes that are basically uninterrupted to mount the water pump with. Okay, next job is to mount the pump. This is the heavy duty pump, not the homemade one that LBSC describes, but it'll fit inside there. As you can see, my plan is to use flathead brass 440 screws that will be countersunk into the bottom, like these screws are countersunk. I'm going to set the assembly. Let me show you one more thing. Set the assembly in there. I'll remove these screws. I was just checking to see the length of the screws and the nuts. But I'll use this center drill, extra long center drill, which will go through the holes here, and I'll be able to drill the starting holes for the pump in the base. And one more thing about the base, I don't know if you can tell or not, but in here there's a piece of 1/16 inch brass. You can see the end of it. It's shorter than the length of the overall, but I just used a piece of scrap that I had, measured the width with some calipers, scribed it out, and then filed it to a nice close fit. And I've marked with blue ink there about where the base will go, so that when I go to mark the spot for the holes, it'll make a nice clear mark. I've just finished installing, well, at least drilling the holes and countersinking them for the mount bolts for the water pump here. And as I mentioned before, this is like the heavy duty water pump. Let me see if I can pull this off without getting all the screws out. I can't. I got some 440 screws here. They're not fastened down. You can see they're a lot bigger. I'm using them to mount the water pump in. I countersunk them, and I'm real pleased with the alignment there. It's important to get this thing straight so it fits through the hole and in the right place to give the best action. I have a little room back here. I'll have to drill a hole and make a fitting for the water pipe to go through the back there, and I need to buy some longer brass for number 4x40 thread flathead screws, but hopefully I can get them at the hardware store. Pretty pleased with tonight's effort. Okay, here's the left-hand side pump, the inboard edge of it. I had to remove this panel in order to get the pump installed. I used stainless steel 440 screws countersunk in the bottom. and some lock washers and stainless nuts. So now it's in position. Next steps for this will be drilling the hole in the back portion here and soldering in a fitting, and then also for the water transfer tube there. I think I'll silver solder those in. That way I can soft solder the rest of the assembly and I shouldn't melt the silver solder. The next step in the process is to drill a hole here for the copper line that's going to come out of the back of the hand pump. And LBSC makes a big deal out about getting the exact right spot, so I came up with the idea of using my height gauge here. So I set the bottom of the height gauge on the top of this, went down an eighth of an inch, and marked it this way. Then I laid it on its side and used the height gauge again. This is a quarter inch fitting, so you can just go down an eighth of an inch, and that should be a pretty accurate spot for it. So I hope that's helpful. Hey folks, I think I'm going to make this the last little segment of this week's episode. I know it's been like a month since I've uploaded, but you can see the tanks. I've been laying out some of the piping parts that I had made previously. I do need to make one more connection. We'll talk about that in the next video. But it just dawned on me that there is a ton of extra work left here to finish this up, and I'm not going to finish it anytime soon, so I wanted to go ahead and publish this one. Please let me know if you have any questions. As always, thanks for being part of the journey. I appreciate you.